That's right. A lot of information coming from Acting Chief Lawrence O'Toole just a few moments ago. I can start by telling you that two suspects are in custody tonight. We don't have their identities, but we know that one is a 22-year-old. The other is a 24-year-old. The two officers who were shot, they had surgery earlier today. They are out of surgery and are expected to be okay. Meanwhile, an innocent woman who was sitting at home while all of this played out, she was hit in the head by a stray bullet. We're told tonight she is in critical condition. Just a few moments ago, police released these images of the guns they say they recovered from the scene. They say both of the guns were loaded. One is an assault-style rifle. The other, what appears to be a Glock handgun. Taking you back to the scene now, Bomarito Automotive Sky Fox was over 14th and Cass, where those officers stopped to make an aid call after Acting Chief O'Toole says they were ambushed a few blocks away. O'Toole says two officers working with the gang squad noticed a person of interest and attempted to stop and interview that person when the suspects opened fire. One officer, a 35-year-old man with 9 years of service, was shot, along with a 32-year-old female officer with 10 years of service. They were shot in the arm, hands, and legs. We've learned within the last half hour, again, that a woman who was innocently sitting in her house when all of this played out was hit in the head by a stray bullet. She is in critical condition. Today's shooting follows yesterday's officer shooting of a man police say was driving a stolen vehicle. Acting Chief Lawrence O'Toole says these incidents are happening as police are trying to get violent offenders off of the street, but dealing with violent offenders has a very dangerous price.
These are violent offenders, and they don't want to be taken. They don't care about anyone else. When they fire an assault rifle like this in a highly urban area, obviously they have total disregard for the safety of anyone other than themselves. So it's something that you deal with when you deal with violent offenders. It's dangerous business.
Again, no identities of the two men police have in custody tonight, but police do tell us that they have prior run-ins with the law. Again, that innocent bystander, that woman fighting for her life tonight in critical condition, while those two officers who were shot are out of surgery and resting at a local hospital. Reporting live tonight outside of police headquarters, I'm Jaron Jordan, Fox 2 News.